Good morning, my brothers and sisters. I welcome you to the morning devotions for Friday, February 5th, 2021. These devotions are brought to you by the Anglican Diocese of the Bahamas and the Turks and Caicos Island. I am Father Peter Ferguson, the assistant curate at St. Christopher's Church, Lyford Key, and St. Agnes Church, Grandstown, New Providence. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you govern all things both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the supplications of your people, and in your time grant us your peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Psalm 27. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? It is said that fear is a dark shadow that envelops us and ultimately imprisons us within ourselves. When we have a problem, we can choose to have either fear or faith. Fear usually puts the focus on us and our situation. Fear can cause us to become sick or even bring about death. On the other hand, faith sets our mind on God's authority, His control of our lives, and acknowledges His goodness. Faith allows us to conquer our fear by trusting in God, who brings us salvation. The psalm written by David reflects how his faith in the power of God sustained him during his many trials. It is clear in this psalm that David's trust in the Lord is evident from the opening declaration of the psalm. He describes the effects of God's protection in his life. He says, "The Lord is the protector of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" And he goes on to say, "The Lord is not only my light and my salvation, but he will not desert me, but will constantly protect me with his shield and will show me his kindness." He proclaims that God is with him even during trouble, and with God's protection, no one can harm him. He carries this proclamation all the way through to the end of the Psalms. He said, "Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord." This is a common theme in David's writing because of the many times he has seen God's truth in his life. From facing a lion in the wilderness to conquering the giant Goliath, David had experienced God's presence and deliverance. My brothers and sisters, God has given us a promise of hope during these hard times in which we live in today. He has offered us his help for our problems today and hope for our future. It is his gifts to us who firmly seek him, those who decide that the one thing they must do before anything else is to behold the beauty of the Lord will be richly rewarded. They will discover that the light of God dispels the confusion, disruption, and despair of darkness, and God will open new prospect for the life of faith. We simply must trust Him, and He will never leave us or forsake us. Let us pray. God, you are infinitely good. Thank you for promising your goodness and faithfulness to us, no matter how hard times get. Give us the confidence that we will see you and be alive with you. Give us your peace that passeth all understanding, and keep our hearts and our mind stayed on you. In Christ's name, amen. Thank you all for tuning in to the morning devotions, and please share this message with your family and friends. Amen.